Hi, I'm Kim Dowling, figure competitor, married with two beautiful children. I've competed in 9 shows, placing first in 4 of them. I'm a PT out at Origin Fitness in Penrith, which I love. I'm currently in training for my first show this year, the NBA City National Totals, held on June 3 at Carlton La Rozelle, followed by the Asia Pacifics the following week on the Gold Coast. Today you'll see myself and Steve Baudo training at Raleigh's gym, putting me through my paces. Today we're doing a full body workout, which is easy to incorporate in any program. We're constantly tapping into the mind-muscle connection, which is critical for any training session. I can be contacted at originfitness.com.au or come down and say hi at the IBA show in June. Thank you.
My name is Steve Baudo. I'm an IFBB and INBA competitor, and I'm also Kim Dowling's training partner, who is the star of Hardcore Aussie Muscle. And we're going to go through a couple of exercises today. And starting off, the first one is going to be our straight arm push down. As you can see, I've got Kim set, so she's slightly lordotic there. She's got that curvature in the back of the spine. She's taking up most of the weight through the heels of her feet. As she pushes down nice and straight, what we're trying to do is cock those wrists right back as far as we can. That way we're switching on that long head of the tricep. You'll notice here that as the weight starts to get heavy, I need to correct Kim a little bit just to push her wrist back as they start to roll forward. This is really crucial with this part of the exercise, because if we neglect this, then we're going to switch those triceps off. We want to keep those on. Have a look at her back. So here we have Kim doing our lat pull down. You'll notice that her thumbs are on the outside of the bar. This helps her use her hands for hooks, and all the power is coming from her elbows. Even though that weight starts to get a little bit heavy, what Kim is doing is she's trying not to pull down as far as possible, because otherwise her shoulders are going to rotate around and over, and that's actually going to switch her lats off. See how she's keeping beautiful form all the way through, holding and squeezing on each movement. And check out those lats, amazing. Here we have our incline dumbbell curl. Notice that Kim is keeping her palms nice and flat all the way through the range of motion. Even as it does start to get heavy, I encourage you to keep them nice and flat. When we get to the end of the range, we want to make sure that we squeeze that tricep at the bottom. That'll give us full range motion. This is one of those exercises where I like to go as heavy as I possibly can, and it's a great partner assist exercise where you want to just give them just enough to get up to the top there. Incline dumbbell press. Here you can see Kim changing the angle of her dumbbell as she comes up. As she gets to the top, she's just twisting it a little bit to try and find that peak contraction. We're trying to press with the meat of the palm, the hand, and when we get to the top, we want to spend just a little time holding and squeezing. Should almost feel like it's kind of tearing. And this is what I call a close set lunge. Most people tend to do their lunges with their feet right back to avoid that knee traveling right over the toe. But I find that if you have a look here, Kim is actually going into a little bit of hip flexion. So she's leaning down, leaning forward, and that's achieving the same result. So you can stay nice and close. Got that heel on the floor, sitting on the plate, and that way it's going to emphasize pushing with the glute. So here we are doing a high set leg press using single leg at a time. And what I'll do is I'll get Kim to put both feet up. The reason being is because if you start out with only one foot, you're going to have a tendency to move your leg right into the center, and that's going to throw your hip alignment out. So we want a natural hip alignment. Plate's there, so we're pushing with the heel. And Kim's going to bash out a set of 10 for us. So foot comes down, and we want a nice full range. Being a competitor and also a judge myself, I understand the importance of symmetry, and often we have one leg weaker than the other, so this is why doing unilateral exercises are really great for a competitor, to make sure that they're developing evenly on both sides of the body. Using a leg press, generally we tend to push more favourably with our better leg, so this is a way to combat that. And with our cable fly, you'll notice that Kim is not necessarily bringing her hands all the way to the end of that range. She's more concerned with putting her mind into actually contracting the pec. Sometimes when it gets a little bit too heavy, we have this tendency to focus more on pushing our hands together rather than contracting our chest. So she's making a big effort to pull those shoulders back, only come as far as she can, contracting the chest without compromising, rolling those shoulders over. And typically holding and squeezing at the end. And our seated rear delt cable pull. You'll notice that Kim sits her feet nice and flat on the floor. And looking at old photos of bodybuilders standing on stage, and you look at them going into that rear double bicep pose, you'll notice there's a really big emphasis on the rear delt muscle being emphasized there. So I thought, why not replicate that same movement under load? So you'll notice Kim leans forward as much as she can, tucking her head in into almost a bit of an abdominal crunch, focusing on those two rear delt muscles there. Big squeeze and hold at the end. Okay, and a shoulder exercise that maybe we don't see often in the gym is the V-press. Kim uses this exercise to develop the medial head of her delts. You'll see here that I'm getting Kim to open her hands up when she gets to the top and let that weight just drop down. So instead of getting those weights to touch together at the top, we're actually pulling them out into a V formation. We don't want to lock our arms right out the top. We still want to keep tension on the muscle when we get to the end of the range. Nice and slow movements and pausing momentarily at the top.
So a big thank you to Riley's Gym for having us here this morning.
And also to High-Quality Muscle. Thanks, guys.
And if you're out at Hornsby Way, Fitness First, come down and say g'day. My name's Steve Baudo.
We hope you enjoyed today's workout. It's basically the full body, so you can see what I do to get ready for a show. If you are interested in coming along, it's the IBA Castleville at the auditorium out there. Beginning of June, go onto the IBA website. Enjoy it, and keep training and stay fit. Cheers.
Cheers, guys.